Hey gurus, it's been a while. Lars is out enjoying some well-deserved time off, so I'll be covering for him this week. While that does mean less llamas, there's no shortage of Azure updates to go over. While this last week didn't have any earth-shattering updates or vulnerabilities that required immediate attention, there were a couple of cool announcements to go over today. Working with managed service providers or managing multiple Azure tenancies just got a whole lot safer with Microsoft's Privileged Identity Manager service integrating with Azure Lighthouse, now going into public preview. For those of you who may not know, Privileged Identity Manager is a service that you can use to eliminate persistent access to elevated roles. You can have users request access to various roles based on need, rather than assigning a role because the person may require it. It's a pretty cool way to ensure a potentially compromised account doesn't get access to everything because your admin was given global administrator rights for all time. Azure Lighthouse is a service that allows you to manage multiple Azure tenancies from a single console, which is useful for things like managed service providers or enterprises that may have multiple tenancies. It really shines for things like user delegation and activity monitoring when you're doing those tasks across multiple organizations. It's a pretty simple product offering, but very powerful and very useful. Bringing the ability to use privileged identity management into Azure Lighthouse makes it so that you'll be able to not only authorize users when they need access for good reason and under expected circumstances, not just because. This gives clients or organizations more control and their respective security engineers better sleep at night. Keep an eye on this if you leverage Azure Lighthouse, because this will be a great method of ensuring security and compliance. All right, let's get serious for a moment. I am a big fan of the classics. Classical music, classical styles, classic cars, but we should all be moving away from Azure Classic Services. Today, roughly 90% of Azure's infrastructure as a service virtual machines are ran by Azure Resource Manager. And if you're still running workloads leveraging Azure Classic, you only have until March 1st of 2023. That may seem like a ways off, but the closer we get to that date, the more pressure you're going to be under. Last week, Microsoft placed their cloud services migration tool into general availability, meaning that it's been tested and it's been found fairly successful. Using this tool, you can have Azure orchestrate the entire migration and any associated resources to leverage Azure Resource Manager. It does this using a three-step method. You validate, prepare, and then commit or abort. You can leverage the ability to test the ARM template it generates before deploying, and Microsoft claims it'll retain any IP address and DNS associations you already have configured. The list of excuses to stay on Azure Classic is dwindling, so rather than wait until the last minute, I'd recommend arming yourself with this tool and getting that migration planned. Azure Communication Service allows you to add voice and video functionality to your application by leveraging Azure's infrastructure if you so choose, or by routing their service to your own telephony solution or carrier. Well, that just got easier. Microsoft followed through on commitments they made earlier this year at Ignite to expand Azure's communication services feature set. Adding on to new features like the call recording functionality and native compatibility with Universal Windows Platform, Microsoft announced direct routing to your telephony system, effectively eliminating the need for middleman infrastructure to utilize your existing telephony solutions. Using this technology, you'll be able to route your application calls directly to your existing carrier or telephony solution with just a few additions to your code. Neat. Well, that's all for this episode, gurus. Next week, Lars should be back to continue to update you on all the Azure goodness, pending his llamas don't revolt and start Llamageddon. That aside, we'd love to hear from you in the comments, or come join the conversation on our Discord server, which we've provided a link to in the description. Network with your peers, join study groups, or just say hi. If you want to keep up with Azure news, consider subscribing to this channel, and if you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Well, gurus, it's been fun. But as we always say here at A Cloud Guru when hosting a show for a friend, seek and you shall cloud. See you next week and keep being awesome, gurus.